What's up, guys? Anklespankin here, and today we are doing something a little different. And I started in Champion Select because I want to have a good chance to be able to talk to you guys before this game starts. So one thing I've been thinking of for a while now is showing that I plan on doing an AD carry to Masters kind of situation, because you know, you have people like Pants doing jungle all the way to Challenger rank 1, you got Red Mercy doing mid to Masters, things like that, but I don't really know anyone doing AD carry who's not already like top of the top Challenger level. Like, I don't know anybody who is in the process of improving and getting to Masters, so I thought maybe I could fill that gap. And I wanted to ask you guys, a couple things about it, because I've been thinking about it a lot and I don't know the best way to attack it. I know a lot of you guys have been asking to see a lot more serious games from me, which I would love to show. The simple fact of the matter is I usually do not play as well when I am recording, as I am focused more on speaking and trying to be entertaining for you guys rather than the game at hand. So I was thinking that maybe I could do a similar thing to what Pants does with his games, where he has, you know, 3 or 4 games per video, just kind of cut up so you can see the game, you can see plays he makes, you can see kind of what he does, what kind of exciting things happen in the game, and you can find the outcome of the game. So I was thinking of doing it kind of like that, but making it more 2 or 3 games per thing and keeping them around like 15 to 20 minute videos. So it was still more of the game. I don't know if I would go that long, but it would still show more of the game. And I also wanted to make it rather informative, because I can ask a lot of my, you know, much higher ranked friends to check these games out with me maybe, and we can have our own little sessions after each game to go over exactly what I did wrong, what I did right during each game, so you guys can learn as well as I can. And part of the whole reason of me, you know, doing this in Champion Select, like I said earlier with talking about it, is also so you guys can see my idea for picking. Now, it looks like I have a Bard support and there will be a Nami support, so my Bard will be doing a lot of damage in lane. There are a couple good AD carries right now. The ones that come to mind, Jhin, Ezreal, and Varus are the top three. And of those three, with a Bard, I would probably... It's hard to say. I mean, but Jhin, Varus, Ezreal, they are all three incredibly safe. So, I mean, as an AD carry, it doesn't really matter. Pick your poison. Just play what you want to play. I'm going to play Jhin this game because I really have been enjoying Jhin and finding a lot of success with him. So, it's kind of hard to choose, like, based on the game, what I would want to pick too, because, you know, I can't see the rest of them yet. So just be a safe AD carry. Jhin, Ezreal, Varus, top three, all very safe, all very good with any support, all pretty damn good against any lane too, so you can pick those all very safely. So as an AD carry, not too relevant with counter picks. Anyways, I did want to know what you guys thought about that though, because it's something I've been really looking forward to doing, and I was thinking of either also trying to record every game solo, or I could have maybe dedicated stream days where I just solo queue for like 4 or 5 hours on this account, which is currently Diamond 5, just so you guys know. It is currently Diamond 5. We would go from Diamond 5 to Masters. I didn't know if I should do that on stream. I didn't know if I should do that as just flat recording. I do not know. They grabbed a Lucian, really? Okay, so... Wait, they got a Lucian, but we got a brand jungle. Okay, alright. Okay, hold on, let me just double check my masteries. So, this is fine, this is all right and good. For Jhin, at least. Of course, Blood Moon Jhin. Alright, looks like the team is really putting a lot of faith in the brand jungle. I think it should be fine, as long as Irelia goes tank, because that's really going to be the only gap we're missing in this game. But their team is going to have the same issue. They are going to have to count on their top laner to go tank as well. So that'll be good for us. I think it'll be fine, honestly. As long as he plays well, it should be fine. But I really wanted to know what you guys thought of it. I wanted to know if you guys were thinking of things that I hadn't thought of as well. You know, whether that be like just some idea with doing this, or some other way I can go about doing it. because I wanted to open it up to you guys so you could discuss it with me a little bit, leave your ideas, give me more angles to consider. So, with all that said, we are going to be going into game here. A little warning, maybe a preface, for the game. I will probably not be as focused on trying to be entertaining when I'm playing these games, because I really want. Obviously, I want to win. I want to win. I want to win. I want to kill them. I want to annihilate them. I want to show you guys I am actually it. Honestly, I feel like I'm a very talented player now. Maybe in the past I wouldn't have felt like that, but now I really do feel truly confident in myself as a player to know that I'm good. So win or loss, like, I want to show you these guys, or show you guys this game, and also hear your guys' thoughts on it. So we'll see how that all goes. Bard is running Thunderlords too. I mean, that's pretty standard on Bard. It's just always funny to see on a support. So he's got Ignite and Thunderlords. He's planning on doing some damage in this lane. And against a Lucian, we can actually go super hard as long as I play it well. Like, if I don't get bubbled, dude, it should be pretty good. And actually, we have a pretty good team against Jax overall. Because we have a lot of magic damage. And Bard can actually keep him pretty... Like, all of our team actually can keep him very CC'd during his Counter-Strike. So we'll be really good. We'll be very well off. And also, guys, I do want to let you know, I have been watching my old videos back when I was not necessarily much more successful, because I still feel I'm doing very well on YouTube, like right now, I still feel I'm doing well, but back when I feel like I had more of a consistent higher view on each video, if that makes sense. Like, I realized that it's not that bad compared to what I thought. I just realized that it's kind of stagnated at this point, and everything, like, I looked around, every League YouTuber is having a hard time growing. The most ridiculous growth on League YouTubers are the streamers. When they're coming over to League, or coming over to YouTube from Twitch, and even then, like, I peaked at 30k subs a month, and, like, the best people right now are getting, like, 12 to 15. So I was like, wow, maybe I really shouldn't feel as bad as I probably do. So, we'll try not to worry about that. It's always one of those things in the back of your mind, though, as a YouTuber, like, everyone always is going to tell you, oh man, don't worry about numbers, they're not going to matter too much. But you can only tell yourself that so much. Like, it is a hard thing sometimes. And our brand actually started with Dark Seal in the jungle, so that's... He didn't even start with a Hunter's Talisman. He started with Dark Seal, so let's see if we can get this. The reason I haven't skilled up yet is because if we actually see someone and get them stunned, I want my W to try and keep them rooted for just a little longer. So let's do it. Bard, go in first. Lead the crusade, little buddy. All right, he found no one there. Let's keep on going. All right, hug the wall. Make sure you keep yourself out of vision as much as you can. It looks like that will be my boy. I actually missed. All right, well, had I landed that, how the fuck did that miss? I cannot believe I actually managed to miss that. Wait, hang on. Whoop! Oh, that's a nail of that one! And will it be a kill? That's gonna be the kill! Oh my god, I got first blood. Nice, dude! Oh, hell yeah. Wait, hang on. Ugh. I didn't even get an assist for that one, dude. Alright. Well, Brand 1-0-1. I really... Oh God, he's going to want a big leash right now. I really want to go back so I can get another longsword to start this lane with. But, you know what? That's not bad, dude. That's really not bad. So we'll just leash this guy. We'll give him a nice and hard leash. Because he is 1-0-1. Is he going to smite this? It doesn't look like it. So we'll give him one more auto attack. That's pretty good start, dude. That's a pretty good start. I mean, I'm going to roll with this gravy train here, and we'll be good. So I'm not going to bother with that one. We'll just W this one. And you know what? Starting with W, I think it's going to be worth the level 1 gimping. I think it's really going to be worth, gimping myself a bit at level 1 here for this. Because 2 kills is pretty damn good, even though I didn't have anything to do with the second one. That's still pretty damn good. So he's... Actually, they're both level 2 already? How the hell did Bargill... Oh, he got solo experience for the first two minions. Gotcha. So let's just work on getting these minions. If you guys do want to know how you can really improve your game just with one thing. Just with one single thing, dude. One single thing. Just work on your CSing. Brand is fucking level 1. Don't level 1 gank us, you Goomba. You're fucking level 1. Go away. Go away. Don't try and CS here. You're go away. Get the fuck out of here, dude. Alright, let's see. Boop. And, Wait, hang on. Okay, there goes that. So let's see. Wait, you missed the stun! Oh my god. I thought you were gonna get that stun. Oops. Okay, well, that's gonna be that. A little over aggressive, maybe. But you know what? I really did think he had it. No problem. I really thought that someone was going to land, and I thought we might have been able to do a little more, because Bard's damage is really ridiculous. That was something that I was kind of counting on there, with me flashing in really aggressively like that onto the Nami. I was hoping I actually forgot she wasn't one of the people that flashed. Do apologize for that. That was just very silly. But let's focus on the game instead. Instead of worrying about mistakes. Because, you know, when you're playing solo queue, sometimes you do just do... Sometimes you make a silly. You know, sometimes you just do a silly. Like that. You do something exactly just fucking goofy like that. In the back of your head, you know you shouldn't have done it, but you wanted to do it anyways. So, my diggity dang. I was kind of really overestimating Bard there, though. I was overestimating Bard, so I'm going to play a much more reserved game like I usually would. Because for some reason, in my head, dude, like, I know I'm recording. So it's like, I can't get the showboater out of here. Where I just go for the most ridiculous plays. So he actually did start with a Doran's Blade. By the way, let me tell you guys that real fast. Since we start with a longsword, that is intentional. It does provide for more sustain in lane due to having 3 potions instead of 1. Where Doran's Blade does give you a higher amount of base health. Both are good. But Doran's Blade, in my opinion, is only better when you have an actual sustaining support, which Lucian does in the Nami. So, it does give you a lot of early game stats, but obviously Doran's Blade doesn't build into anything. So, let's see. Boop. And he's gonna actually go down there. Lucian pulling a silly, almost as silly as Anklespankin right there, is gonna get himself killed. So... That was Nami's exhaust right there as well. Let's go ahead and ping that. Because right there, 2 things, dude, that you can do to improve your game immediately. Make sure you try and time summoner spells and work around those time frames. Because if you know the cooldowns for summoner spells, you can work around when they're up. If you want easy ways to remember them, for instance, in this lane... Oh, damn. Nice, Bard. He found their jungler, so he's going to get himself a roaming kill there. 2-0-2 on the bar, goddamn. But an easy way to remember it is exhaust, as you can see, 179, and that... Oh, she's actually, you know, specced into it. So, 3 minutes for exhaust. Usually, they're actually the same cooldown. So, if I can look at this and see his ignite's up, boom, exhaust is up. But since she has the mastery, it's actually going to be up a little sooner. So, not a big deal, but you know what? That is fine. So let's actually grab our full Caulfield's Warhammer here. Shouldn't have waited in base so long, but I wanted the Caulfield's Warhammer. Because we are going to be going straight for the Yomu's Ghostblade. Very simple stuff. We don't have any potions, but that's okay. That is okay. But usually when you have summoner spells that, like, you know someone on your team used one at a very similar time, you can kind of base it off of that. But it's probably easier just to kind of memorize it. Like, I can see here that I pinged Nami's exhaust. So at about 8:30, she'll have her exhaust back. So that's... There you go. Just remember that. Try and keep that in mind, because that will be the difference between winning or losing a fight. That will absolutely be the difference between winning or losing a fight. And right now, I don't want to go aggressive, because since my Bard's not here, we do have the Brand jungle behind our Bard right now. So if they do get aggressive on him, that would still be okay. And Brand, he does have his jungle item now, so that's a start. He's getting there. Let's see, the ultimate is around, but like I was saying, don't want to get too aggressive on these guys, because, oh no, oh no. Alright, let me go ahead and just eat some of these, and, whoa, god damn! Alright, flashing aggressively. So he did use the flash, whoa, alright, that's going to be one kill right there, probably. Alright, there goes the heal, wait, there's the flash, the miss, that is unfortunate, he's going to go down, that's, oh no, that's so bad, oh no. He just autoed a minion, dude! Oh no, man. Oh, now Lucian is huge. What? You just autoed a minion when you would have killed him. You just fucking autoed a minion when you would have killed him. Oh my goodness. Okay. Alright. Alright, so this guy's a little something. So let's see here. This guy's gonna be recalling right there, and maybe we can just catch him out. Wait, where the fuck did he go? He's a god! Alright, let's just aim that last one to the side. So I guess he just immediately saw the ult and ran. So easy enough. Oh, there he was. So there it is. There it is. So we'll go ahead and grab these. Maybe if I actually canceled that ultimate and ran at him, I could have found him. So he dashed out of there, dude. He was out of there in an instant. So that's... Dude, that is so unfortunate, man. That sucks so much that he blew that so bad. Like, I did too. Lucian did that early aggression thing that Lucian does. And Bard is going to be gone here. So we're going to have to play the real far back game, unfortunately. I don't like to when I'm playing Jhin. Especially when I had a really solid early advantage. Granted, I was the one that blew that. I did mess that up by trying to go super aggressive at a bad time. I thought maybe my bard's little hot cocos would have been enough for me to live off of there. But seems to not be the case. So let's grab that. Can you get that one too? He can. Look at this guy, I'm just feeding him money now. So maybe boom! Get bounced on. Doesn't matter too much though. Alright, boom, 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 double bounce! Oh, only a single bounce. Alright, we got Kindred right there, so we're just gonna back off of this. I do have my ultimate soon. And I would say we should wait for our jungler to gank, but it's a Brand and he's kind of just a flamer. You know, Brand, flame, haha. But we'll see. We'll see how this goes. We might just want to play the far back game here, because Lucian is, you know, at his, I wouldn't say his peak of strength, but he does have the Yomus on us, and with Nami, he can be very powerful, because Lucian dashes forward at you with the Nami-empowered auto-attacks, and it's like, well, shit, what do I do now? Because you just get slowed, and basically, in this situation, I would have to flash out. And I would kind of have to flash more perpendicular to him, because fucking his ultimate, so that's okay. This lane does suck though. Originally we had to just take it by the balls. Lucian's really not that good of a champion right now, but adversely, if he steamrolls you, he can still get a real solid dickin' on you. So let's see, he did bust the Yomus there. We're just gonna run far, far away and go for this. So, actually, I can go grab my Yomus right now. I think I should do that. Bard is going to roam real fast. Aurelion's soul is going to be taking a lot of damage. Is he going to get the kill here? No, he will not. The flash for the flash. Looks like the Bard ultimate, along with that ultimate, will be coming out. Bard fighting. That's going to be one kill. Bard's being a silly goose. Definitely, I think he's overestimating himself at this point. So, apparently... It's pretty unfortunate. Oh well. Oh well. So we might... I might actually lose this tower here. No, we're not. So Brand is coming in, but I don't think he's gonna get to be doing much here. Now, one thing to remember about the ELO that we're starting from right here is that, you guys will get to see it firsthand. Diamond 5, there's a reason. If you've ever been on my streams, Diamond 5, I've always said, is by far my least favorite to climb out of. Every single time I've been here, it has been my least favorite to climb out of. It is so bad, because everyone is like, oh, I'm Diamond, that means I'm the greatest player ever now. And they just... They roll with it, dude. They go with that idea alone, that they are the absolute pinnacle of League of Legends talent. And, well, it's obviously not very true. So that should be that. Ocean Drake going down. You would think that Ocean Drake would be super effective against Brand, but guess not. I should not be here. So, I'm going to flash out of this, actually. Even though I have two people down here, I don't think Brand's going to be very useful with the amount of mana they had. And if I flash immediately, I can actually preserve my health instead of just eating the choline and potentially dying. So, now I still have a lot of health. I was able to stay in lane. I think an early flash there was very warranted, because Lucian does do a lot of damage. Like, a lot of damage right now. He's got, actually, a second serrated Dirk, so he's going for the Edge of Night, which is pretty standard. Pretty gosh darn standard right now. No surprise there. So, we'll see what we can do, though. We are, unfortunately, almost 30 CS down. And I wish I could say that was my fault for poor CSing. But I really haven't been doing that badly on the CSing. It's been a lot of the fact that, well, Bard's been roaming. And that's not inherently a bad thing, but it does really impact my CSing, because I can't go up and safely CS. And now I still can't, even with Bard here. So, there goes that. It's going to be some damage. Go ahead and just, hey, get out of the way of that, you silly goober. I want those. I want those minions. Auto Q, start bouncing. Ooh, that's going to be the Bard ult coming in. Now let's see if I can just drop the ultimate here. That's not going to tag me. That's going to be one shot. It's going to be another shot. And wa-boom! Oh, you bitch. All right. Beep. So nail that. That's going to be... Oh, cool. I got the kill. So the DFT will be getting the kill for me. We'll be getting two kills down here. Super good for us. This gives us a chance to get some more work done on this tower. And we do have another wave crashing in here as well, so we might actually be able to get this. So that'd be super good. And that should kill it. Nice. Nice, nice, nice. 108 CS, still isn't bad. I mean, I should be more around what this guy has right now, because that's much better than what we've got. But, you know, as I went over, you guys have seen what's been going on. Irelia is actually getting pretty damn big here, and that is some good stuff. So first turret gonna go down. I'm actually gonna get solo first turret gold, which is even better for us. So hell yeah, dude. Hell yeah. Is Lucian gonna go for me? It doesn't look like he's going for me. Just keep an eye on him though. Make sure that, you know, we don't get interrupted in our recall. So we'll grab that. We are gonna be going for the Edge of Night ourselves. Very standard item here. For Jhin, the build is Edge of Night. Well, Yomu's Edge of Night. Actually, I just realized Swiftness Boost might help a lot in this lane. Because if I get Swiftness Boost, I can kind of outrun... Not outrun, but, you know, kind of outperform Lucian's ultimate, so... Brand. I'm just gonna mute Brand, because honestly, all he does is sit there and be a total idiot, and then flame other people for it. And I actually can't go under tower right now. So, I'm just gonna give it up. I can't do anything about it. Kindred is going for this mark. Orianna's over here as well. We can't... Can't do shit. We cannot do shit right now. So let's see. Let's see. Can I go for this? I'm going for it. I'm definitely going for it. That's one kill. And that's going to be the ultimate from Nami interrupting me. The W is going to come out. Maybe I can do something here. I don't think I can. Do not think I can. So I got my ultimate. I got the kill. We'll be a 1-for-1 for their invade. Could have been a lot worse. Could have been a lot better. Could have been definitely a lot worse. Oh, the stun is not going to land. But let's see. Oop, that's going to be the kill for Brand. So no need to use my heal there. We'll be we'll be a slight flame from our Aurelian Soul. That will be a rampage for Irelia and a third kill for us. Definitely brought it back from our 1-2-1 after, you know, 1-0-0 start. But you know what? Sometimes you get cocky, sometimes you make mistakes. Let's go back. We just pushed that out. We should go mid now, I think. Because I can get this. I can also grab this. And I will also be grabbing a dagger. And actually, while I'm here, I'll also grab a control ward, because I do have the money and the inventory space. Brand, still not landing the Q there. I don't know if I've actually seen him land a stun yet. Not, no flame, but I actually don't think I've seen him land a stun yet. Another thing that you gotta remember when you're playing solo queue, always honestly do your best not to flame. Like, even the most toxic players I've ever met, even they say the same thing. In ranks, dude, a positive mindset and actually, you know, complimenting your team or just trying to be friendly, trying to defuse a bad situation, it actually helps. Like, it really does help. So let's see here. And whoop, that's gonna be a kill. Easy, easy right there. But just trying to be a good guy, it really does help a lot more than a lot of people give it credit for, because people just react better. And when they're not tilted, when they're not annoyed, people play better. So everything just goes better when you're trying to be a friendly player, a nice person, anything along those lines. And actually, Brand, I think Brand's already on it, but right now, since that top tower is low and everyone was already bottom, Dragon is spawning, but it's only a Cloud Drake. It's only Cloud. It's only Cloud. I don't know if we want to do this. Actually, we do have Irelia and me with my ultimate. We definitely do want to do this. Because Irelia can get her tower at any time. If we get this Cloud Drake right now, that's going to be much better. Plus, it's Kindred's mark. So we definitely don't want to let Kindred get her mark. Yeah, definitely the right choice. In top tower, Irelia can get that pretty much any time she wants. So not too worried about that whatsoever. We'll go back here and grab our swiftness boost, though. Excuse me. Had the hiccups. We will go back and grab our swiftness boost, so we'll be running like a little NASCAR run around the rift. Let's go back here. So if we get top, that would be all three outer turrets. You know, global or global gold. You know, jungle pressure, because actually when you have no turrets, you have more access to your enemy's jungle because they have less places to retreat to. So you can feel a little safer going a little deeper in the enemy's jungle. So with Irelia still going bottom, I'm actually going to work my way up top. I'm going to drop this control ward right there. And I'm going to just say that I want this tower. I want to get this tower. So let's see. Maybe I missed. Alright, so let's go ahead and just grab this tower. No problem. And since I was there for local gold, that'll help a lot. Lucian dashing forward on that turret. I don't want to... I'm not in danger of walking through here as long as I'm with Irelia. As long as I'm with Irelia, there is nothing that I truly need to be scared of. So it looks like, let's see, I'm going to prepare my Edge of Night here. Open this up. That's going to be one shot. The Edge of Night will block that. Wait, what kind of a glitch was that, dude? What kind of a goddamn glitch was that? Oh, no. Oh, no. All right, and get me over here. What kind of a fucking glitch was that? If you guys didn't know what that glitch was, basically, what just happened to me was, oh, damn, dude! Oh, damn! Fuck. Okay, but basically, Nami's ults... fucking... it took my Edge of Night off. Like, it popped my veil, as we knew it would. But it also actually completely took me out of the zoom of my ultimate. Like, it took me out of my large camera for my ult. That's really annoying. And the fact that that was a 3-2 surrender vote, we could have just surrendered there if I said yes. All because someone was a big ol' fucking baby because we lost one fight that played very poorly is pretty pathetic. That's pretty pathetic, and that speaks volumes for the morale of people here. So... In low diamond. So that's pretty shameful, actually. Like, even kills, dude. Even kills. We have two dragons. A 6-1 Irelia with 174 farm. We've got a lot going for us, dude. We have got a lot going for us. Alright, we don't want to do this. We don't want to do this, and we want to run up. Bard is being a little risky right now. He's giving us a little risky business. We'll grab that minion right there. Infernal is important. Infernal is very important. So let's see. I don't know if I can go for... I don't think I can go for anything here. Now let's see. Get the ultimate off right there. And I'm gonna miss that fourth shot. Not a big deal. Aurelian at least didn't die. So let's see. He's not gonna. If we had literally anyone behind him, that could have been really good. Because he dashed forward incredibly aggressively there without even having like full health or anything. Set trap there. Set one here. So, Irelia wants to fight. We need to wait for Irelia to actually get here to fight, though. Because obviously we don't want to fight when Irelia is not actually here. That's a pretty bad idea. Let's go ahead and use this Edge of Night, though. Walk in here. Do have the sweeper and a big wave coming up top. It looks like this could be good. This could be good. This could be good. Alright, that's one kill. That's for sure one kill. Let's see. I just realized how bad that could have been, dude. I just realized how bad that could have been. And Irelia will 1v1 out the Jax. That's even better. That's even gooder. That big top wave, though, is still getting under my bones. Well, it looks like Irelia's gonna go down. But not for nothing. Ooh, a good flash right there. We'll stop the stun from coming out. Now let's see. Boop. All right, so I did hit her. I did, in fact, hit her. Redemption is down as well. So let's see, maybe. Alright, there goes Orianna's ultimate as well. Maybe. Okay. I'm gonna drop the ultimate here. One shot. Two shots. Wait, I'm missing completely. And. Oh no, dude. I missed completely. Oh no. I'm just missing everything. I'm just missing everything. That's totally my bad, though. Totally my bad, though. Wait. Wait, hang on. Alright, we do have the teleport coming in. This could be super good. Maybe? And use my heal off on her. Wait for that Counter-Strike to come out before I start autoing again. Boom, that's going to be the kill. That's going to be 3 assists for that heal. Whew. That's a big swing of gold. And we should go down here and work on this. So, I'm going to work on this for just a second. Get this under the tower. I don't need to be there pronto just yet. Because, well, no one's here. I'm going to work on getting this tower first. Because they don't need me to get that Infernal right now. They have no one up. So, like, it's not like anyone's just going to stop us from... Wait, I need to run. I need to dip skis. Alright, I'm slow. Oh, she has a frozen mallet. No! 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 I'm getting outplayed! I'm getting outplayed! Alright, big outplay potential there. But we will get the Infernal, so that's super good. Rapid Fire Cannon is completed for me. And they don't have any armor really yet at all, so I don't need to worry about Last Whisper still for my 6th item just yet. We do need to go for that Infinity Edge next. And after that, we will see. But for now, just go for the Infinity Edge. And everything will be all hunky-dory. Now, the reason you go for a rapid-fire cannon on Jhin, obviously being able to crit on every bullet instead of just your fourth, is, you know, a pretty big boon. The attack speed and the crit both give you AD, so it is a pretty hefty item as far as just AD goes on Jhin. And also, the increased auto-attack range is super nice. Look at that auto-attack range, dude. That bumps you up to 700. So that's pretty damn sweet. Looks like Lucian's going for an Infinity Edge now. He's going for it. So let's see, maybe. Ooh, boom! That's gonna be that snare. That's gonna be the kill right there. Nailed it! We might actually be able to go for Baron off of that, honestly. Because without Lucian, that's a pretty hefty amount of their power, in all honesty. So, I don't know. Whoa! Okay. Well, there goes Irelia. Okay. Wait, hang on. Ooh, come on! Yes! Whoop! Wait, hang on. Ooh, she's a god. Okay, hang on. So let's prepare the veil here. Actually, let's just get out of this. 3 for 3, I mean, honestly, with our Irelia going down, That went a lot better than it had any business going. So I'll take it, dude. I will definitely take that. I'm gonna go get this bot farm, and we'll see, dude. If how'd you go by? I'm already down here, bro. I'm already down here, bro. I mean, yeah, I guess they can bear him pretty fast with what's his face, Kindred. But oh, she doesn't even have her teleport, so it's not like it matters. So give me all this farm. That's a lot of money in the pocket. And actually, another Infernal. So if we can actually get two Infernals, dude, that would be massive. Absolutely massive. I should W this. I should actually clear this wave. Fuck. So I should clear this wave, because if I don't, this will not be pushing. So, actually it would have been pushing, but still important to get it. And we'll go grab our BF sword for the Infinity Edge. So do that. I could. Oh, I didn't get it in time. Not gonna worry about it. Irelia's soul is gonna get ulted. Irelia going hard here. We'll be able to get one kill right there. She's gonna go down though. Maybe the Bard ult. Oh, is not gonna keep her alive, but the Kindred ult will. Can she get this? Oh, she will. So that's two for her life. That's not bad. That's not bad. But that is still Lucian alive, so that's bad. Hoop. Yep. Yep. And boop. Get out of my face, little boy. Get out of my face. Get back in my face, little boy. And boom! Oh, the Aurelian? And the stars, dude. The Stargazer will be picking him up. 6, 3, and 11. We do have everyone up except Irelia, so we will do this Baron. Now, I don't know if getting Baron will be the best choice when we have no tank. So this is going to be, no, it won't be a little iffy. I just realized the damage we have with Brandon, well, my fourth shot. So this should be, oh, I want to get the smite. Boom! Oh, okay. No smite for me. So I'm going to go up here, get this farm as well. My farm is staggeringly low right now, but it's all good. It's all good. We're still definitely having a very large effect on this game in a positive way. So that is good for us. I should not push another one. I should not try and push another one. Now, one thing to remember is that for the next Infernal Drake, in a minute and 40 seconds, we will have this Baron buff. We will be empowered, and we do want to fight with it, because we want that Infernal super badly. And we'll see if we can get it. And if I keep ulting well, I was able to snag Lucian there with a solid donk on the noggin. So good aim is all you really need on Jhin to succeed. But we'll see if we can, pull it out of our hats. Because I would very much like to. Very, very much like to. I am almost just about to be 16. Irelia actually will be getting caught. That's extraordinarily bad. But, oh, I will land that. So some big damage going off there. The flash coming out as well. I could try and ult that, but I don't think it's a good idea. Do not think it's a good idea. So Irelian will be getting one kill there. And I will... Ooh, I actually missed. So let's see. Whoop. Alright, I don't have the fucking Edge of Night active. God bless it, dude. God bless it. Alright, can I get out of this one? Alright, let's see. That still hit me? That sucks. Damn it, dude. Gunblade OP. Man, I thought I had my Edge of Night still active. So we should not have fought in general right there. But we might actually stop trying to fucking surrender. You big whiny baby. What a fucking bitch, dude. Honestly, this guy's really aggravating. I'm so glad I muted him, because I would seriously just want to rip his head off right now because he's so annoying. We're actually not going to even lose the inhibitor off of this. If anything, yeah, we're just gonna maybe lose Dragon. So if Bard can get in there in time, Irelia might be able to help stop this. So maybe, I know if, ooh, she's not going to, the exhaust and the ults. So they are going to get Infernal. But Kindred will lose her life. We should try and get a fight off of this. So that's okay, that's okay. Does anyone still have Baron? Irelian doesn't. I don't. Bard does. Bard actually still has the Baron buff. So that is, one is all you need. We should push with Baron and Kindred down, or Bram die. I also like that strategy. I also like that strategy where Bram just decides to die because he's in their jungle for no reason. So let's see. Maybe. Maybe. I'm taking some heavy damage, but let's get this Edge of Night prepared. And. Whoop! Alright, do some sweet damage there. And I'm not gonna. Actually, I could go for this. Aurelion Soul is on the side. So let's see. Maybe. Hoop! 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 Alright, I got the shots off. No, no, no! Help me! Okay. I can't do anything to him, dude. I need peel for Jax. Unfortunately, there is literally nothing I can do. And as much as I hate to say it, we need Brand's damage. We have to have it. Like, we absolutely have to have it. As much as I hate to admit it, Brand does do a lot of damage just by hitting his R button. But if he's not going to be... If he's going to be a bit of an idiot, truthfully, and just get himself caught out, that's really bad. So what do I need this game? Should I go for a Guardian Angel or should I go for a Mercurial? They don't have a lot of CC. So I don't know how good a Mercurial would be. And Guardian Angel would only give me a delay to my death from Jax, but it does give me hybrid defenses to try and stop him. Also, Ninja Tabi are pretty damn good in this situation as well. Ninja Tabi would help me quite a lot. So let's see. That's going to be a kill off on him. So that's good. We should... As with what we should have done last time, we should have tried to do something with What's-His-Face going down. So that is a good kill. I'll figure out what I need to purchase here in just a moment. Irelia is coming in, so... Damn, dude. I'm actually going to drop this right here. I'm going to get this right now. Since we're not actually doing anything else, I should just clear objectives, any objective, big or small, off the map that I can. And this is so iffy. But at least there's three of us here. There's three of us here, so we don't need to be too careful. Okay. Okay. So definitely just wait for Bard to get in position before I take that. At least, This game got really hard, dude. Out of nowhere, this turned into a really, like, good game. So I'm gonna grab a chain vest here. I definitely think I'm gonna go for Guardian Angel. I think it'll be the right choice. And Baron is up in a minute, so we should try and keep that in mind. Elder is up in 2 minutes, so we don't have to worry about that for the minute during Baron. Definitely keep my distance here. Now, let's see. I do need my Edge of Night. I need to use it right before I ult. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I have to use it right before I ult. Because if I don't, Nami just waves me, and that's that. That is that. That's all she's been using her ult for in fights. That's all she's been... I don't want to say existing for, but that's all she's been doing with her ultimate in fights. And if we get a catch right here, this is perfect. This is actually perfect. So let's see. Go, go, go. Go, go, go. Go, go. Go, go, go. Oh, he hit the Jax. Let's see. I missed. Fuck. Wait, why'd I ult this? I'm retarded. I'm actually retarded. Okay, whatever. So I'll set this down. Got some damage off on him. Looks like Irelia found him. And kaboom. Look at that damage, and I didn't miss that time. I'm going to use my heal off on him. Drop the Q. Drop the Q. Oh, that's huge! Oh. Ooh. Okay, I got the kill off on Jax. Damn, dude, I didn't even see Orianna's ball. Is that going to be enough to lose the fight, though? No, Aurelion's still up. Brand's still up. This should be fine. The Q, what? Oh, the Zhonya's, dude. Nice Zhonya's. It should be enough. Maybe? Oh, he went for the play. Unfortunately, she had already gotten the Q off, though. Honestly, that was a really, really good Orianna ult. That was a beast Orianna. Honestly. I didn't even see it. I truly didn't even see it. That was so good. Alright, let's see. So, Brand is coming in. Wow, that Q is off in left field. That's all right. I got top. Oh, wait, never mind. So she's got top. We could... Oh, they're coming in. They're coming in. So I'm going to run through top here. All I'm going to do is throw a Q. I'm just going to drop a trap and throw a Q and run. Just to try and help clear that wave a little bit and bring it with me. So they do have what's-his-face right there. They do have that one right there. So let's see. Oh, no. Oh, jeez. All right, if they get Baron, that's fine. That's fine. They got the Baron. And now I think I'm still going to die? But they got the Baron. I didn't even see Jack Seed. That's okay. As long as they got the Baron, that's good. I'm gonna get... I'm fucking selling these for Ninja Tabi right now, dude. They'll be so much better for me. Like, Ninja Tabi alone would have made me take 12% less damage from both of those guys combined. They're so good against Lucian. So, four people with Baron is really good. That gets it off the map. They are going for Elder, though. And that Jax is just fucking me, dude. He is fucking me sideways. And that is, as soon as I saw the Jax pick, that is exactly what I was worried about. This is a hard matchup for me. Those two could be in a bad spot. Aurelion needs to get out. Aurelion's dead. Aurelion's fucked. So Aurelion had really stupid pathing there, straight up. He needed to go back, hit this blast cone, and get over here. So, we cannot fight them for 2 minutes. We cannot fight them for 2 minutes. If we do, it's just going to spell certain disaster. Fortunately, we do still have a tower up for every inhibitor. I don't have my Guardian Angel active, so I'm actually just going to prepare the Veil, use this right now. She's going to go ahead and try and ult me out of it. I don't really care. Now let's see. So I don't actually want to fight. This just gets them off of the tower right now. So good stuff. That's all we got to do. That's all we have to do is get them off of that tower. And all we have to do is not fight for another minute. Without my ultimate and Brand's ultimate, we still are missing a lot of damage. But Aurelion is coming up soon. So that's good. I don't have my flash either for if Jax gets on me. So my positioning has to be much better. I have to be thinking much further ahead. Much further ahead, dude. I'm surprised Aurelion didn't go in harder to force out that Kindred's ultimate there. That's okay. That is okay. It's going to be stressful, man. This game is stressful. Let's go ahead and just cue this. Get minions where we can. I'm a full build Jhin. I am a full build Jhin right now. So this is... Alright, yeah, I agree with going top right now. Because they are not... Like, I know it sounds really obvious, but I agree with going top because they are not top. If they are not top... That means that's more time that we get away from them while they have that Elder Dragon buff on. And we also have a massive wave that we can buff with Baron Strength here. It's like Irelia's going to be going hard on this. I'm going to prepare the Veil. I'm going to throw my ultimate down right here. So let's see. Ba-boom. Ba-boom. And ba-boom. Use that. That's a decisive fight. And maybe get the fuck out of here. Dude, that's the game right there. Clean ace, Brand with a triple kill, sitting right in the bush, and me baiting him with my ultimate there. I knew that Lucian was going to go gung-ho straight for me, dude. That's going to be the end of the game. That was a good game, dude. Honestly, that was a mighty fine game. 8-7-17, a respectable score for a Jhin. Maybe a little less kills than we would have liked, but you know what? It's not bad. It's really not that bad. So let's see. Can I get the credit for that one too? Can I get the 50 gold? And ba-boom! 50 gold right there, plus 50 will be the victory with the Brand Jungle. Very toxic Brand Jungle, actually. I'm probably going to report this guy because I... You know, I'm an outstanding citizen of the League of Legends community, and I want to be rid of this sick filth. So you know what? Consider yourself reported. Why, you guys watching this? You guys watching this? Boom. Boom. 19 LP, 41 and 40. Nice, I finally got my win rate positive on this account. Woo! Woo! I did it! And let's look at this. My damage was definitely not very high. Brand doing the most. No surprise. Still a dick. Damage definitely lower than it could have been. But you know what? I still did quite a decent amount overall. And I still did a lot of impactful things, I feel. Or at least had more of a positive impact than a negative one. And that for me at 11 in the morning is good enough. So if you guys did enjoy this video, do make sure you leave a like and a favorite. Make sure you guys do let me know what you think about what I was asking you guys in the beginning of this video, because it was a lot to get off my mind. I want to know if I should do this more as like a series where I do each individual game. I don't think I should though, because that would take way too long. I want to do it more chopped up. I think that would be better. But should I record each game individually, or should I stream them and try and be myself? Well, I mean, obviously I'm trying to be myself. That's one thing I also wanted to tell you guys about, but I'll save that for another time. So let me know what you guys think. Please, 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 please. And also, if you guys liked this kind of serious gameplay where I was more focused on the game, trying to not be shit than anything else. But like I said, if you guys did enjoy this, make sure you leave a like and favorite. It does help me out. If you want to, you can join my Discord or follow me on Facebook, Twitter, or Twitch. All four links will be in the description below. And as always, I love you guys. I hope you have a wonderful day. Peace!